Hello, this is ZDs. I am doing a new type of video today. I have neglected the Facebook community and my friends since I've started doing these videos. I am going to play a few levels by good friends of mine from the Facebook Super Mario Maker 2 community. Some newer levels from them. We're starting off with Prof X's Ninja Speedrun. This is, he has made several lately. Prof X is a Twitch streamer, a fairly popular maker. He's made, I would guess, hundreds of levels. He's played the game more than anyone I know. I can't remember what the last statistic was, but probably three times as much as I have, and I have like 2,500 hours into the game. Yeah, he's a major guy. I've played plenty of his levels. He's played a ton of mine, and he made a series of ninja speedruns. Now I'm starting off. I start off going a little too fast. I really just needed to explore the level. It's not like I'm going to get the record, and in fact, that's my goal here. I want to get to the record. If you looked at it, it was kind of hard to see, but the person who has the record right now is Jay Bizzle. I don't know if he's a streamer, but he is a popular maker. I've seen him, his levels played by Beast, the Beast, 721. I know he's a popular maker. I assume he's makes really hard levels, he's probably a good player. I don't know if the prof knows him or not, or if he just stumbled on this level. But 29 seconds. 29, I think. I can't remember 0.9. We'll see when I beat the level here in a minute. Yeah, I played around a lot in the first room, and then I realized that I should really go to the subworld to see how many I have to kill. 21 dry bones. So I should really see. Let's see what his 29.891 is his record. My first finished score was 143. This level, by the way, has a 49% clear rate when I start. I don't show it at the end, but I start over a lot. I actually lowered it to about 29%. And I probably gave it 9 or 10 clears myself. Yeah, I'll say when Nintendo was making the ninja levels, I was not big on them, mostly because it's like a singular thing that everyone can do. So there are always going to be players who are way better than I am. You know, the Beast, Panga, Mitch Flower Power, those guys are gonna end up with the final scores. I know a few people who actually got they gave out medals at one point. I know a few people who actually got those, but yeah, I never had a chance. And you know, I didn't bother with them. Prof's levels, this one hasn't been played that much. It'll probably get played. I'm sure the record that I ultimately got is probably already gone, as far as I know. I haven't turned the game on today. It's just about finding the most efficient route, and so I play around a lot. I start over if I think I messed up. I know the way to the goal now, so I don't have to explore anymore. Now it's just a time to improve my speed. My first idea was definitely staying on this bottom path. I never did try it, but I kind of wanted to fly up and do the slam. But there's not a lot of dry bones in any one spot. So I might kill two or three of them, but like these conveyors would be a good place to fly up. But, I also think I'd just probably get hit by these bones flying everywhere. And the subworld mostly just goes down. There's a bunch of slopes, so the thought is you should just slide and kill them all. There's a Yoshi you see in the first room. The Prof X loves Yoshi. Yoshi is his favorite thing in this game. So I kind of figured that there might be a way to do it with Yoshi, but the more I explore, I don't see him possibly being the solution to going fastest. It's possible though. It just takes a long time to grab him, and there's no dry bones nearby. I think that was the second finish, maybe third. I didn't count. Yeah, I stay on the bottom for a long time. I feel after a while, these conveyors were really screwing me over. They were holding me back. I also really like that kill with the throwing the spiny shell up. you get one extra kill. It's not really that great. Yeah, a lot of spinies in this area. A lot of dry bones in this area. So this is kind of where you want to get most of your kills. Let's see where I am right now. I think this is the third or fourth finish. I don't remember. So we're at 40. We're still 11 seconds above Jay Bizzle. Quite a bit. Quite far. Yeah, these conveyors were really screwing me over. I don't know why. It kept going this way. See, there's a lot of donuts in here. What you call them? I can't remember what they're called in the game. Those screwed me up a lot too. I eventually tried to find the path of least resistance with those donuts. Once you hit them, you're kind of screwed. Let's see where we are. 38, 9 seconds, we're getting closer. And here's where I kind of find the ultimate route. I don't take it right away, but... that gives me the most dry bones. Oh, I like this death, that's why I kept it in. I screwed up and bounced off two different dry bones. Yeah, I don't remember how much I kept in here, but... I didn't keep it. I still try to go on the bottom for a long time. I don't know if I just accidentally went up this way. But yeah, the more I saw this up top, I was like, man, I'm getting a lot of them really fast here. So I found that, like, after I started doing this, it was like, I screw up that pretty bad. Figure get as many as I can in that first room and on that route, and then I can get the rest in here. And I totally missed the big one. Bounced right off his head. Yeah, I screwed up too much. Start over. I probably cut out 50 different times I started over on this level. I brought the clear rate down quite a bit, but I was just after the record. I'm not going to finish it every time. I feel like the people who play these levels are like I did when Nintendo made the Ninja. It's like, I'm only going to play it once. You know, I'll beat it. I'll have fun with it, but I'm not going to actually grind for it because there are people better than me. And, you know, most people who finish the level the first time probably had over a minute, and they're like, well, I ain't gonna get anywhere close to 29 seconds. You have to have 340 on the clock, by the way, to get under 30, or, yeah, under 30 seconds. Prof likes the 420 timers. I don't know what that means myself. Getting more efficient on that first room. Eventually decide that I don't need to hit the springs. That they're slowing me down. But I don't know if that's true or not, really. I actually have 22 kills in this run. Where are we now? 32. We're 3 seconds above. Less than 3 seconds above. Getting a lot better. At this point, I've found my ultimate route through this first room. Now I have to find that I missed the pipe, of course. Because going down a pipe, or especially up a pipe in Mario Maker, is gonna be a huge pain in the butt, right? The last time I played Super Mario World and entered a pipe, I almost fainted. You go right in no matter where you hit it. Got 22 kills on this one, too. I think I improve on every finish. If only by a little. Yeah, still a little more than 2 seconds above. I'm gunning for you, Jay Bizzle. I don't know if Jay Bizzle is the type to immediately reclaim his records. Some people are like that. I'm not, usually. If I really like a level, I might go back, but usually I just give up. If somebody takes it from me, I don't really care. Maybe if I worked really hard. See, I bounce off the donut and I accidentally find my route. This is my ultimate route right here. I just have to avoid the donut next time. Oh, only like a second and a half below ya. I see a couple of improvements I can make on this final run, but, and this is just my route. There could be faster routes, I don't know. Taking these stairs straight to the pipe is great. You also get to avoid all those donuts. What are they called? I can't remember what those things are called. I don't like them. I don't use them. Prof likes them, though. And we ultimately... 29.455, which is about a half a second below. It's not a great finish. I think I could do a little better, but... probably not a lot. Okay, on to the next level, already in progress. I started filming this one and looked down at my computer after I had already beaten it once, and I was not recording. Or I was recording, but I was recording a blank screen for some reason. The level is MCW UK's Toadette's Thwomp Takedown. Fortunately, I always play as Toadette, so I could take down the Thwomps with her. MCW UK, a YouTuber. He has a nice YouTube channel for Mario Maker 2 if you want to check that out. He's got a very recognizable style to his levels. They're usually very fun. This one is actually one of my favorites of his. It's just some thwomp jumping up and down. Z spinning on some thwomps, avoiding thwomps. I had already beaten this, and I was actually at this point going for the record. I do that on most levels that aren't like super hard. Levels that I think I can actually get a record on. Like if it's a Kaizo level, there are people who are much better at optimizing Kaizo levels than I am. I'm just happy to be one of those. This one, once I beat it once, I knew I could get through it pretty easily. I left some deaths in here just to give you a feel for the level. But eventually we will go for the ultimate world record run. I'm skipping all these checkpoints. This is a very fun level. I was actually, when I was putting the video on, I was watching MCW UK's new level where he samples some Japanese hot garbage. Highly recommended. Very funny so far. It's a nice race. I think this might be the life where I beat this one. I'm not sure. This auto scroll section, obviously, there's not much you can optimize here. But there is a boss fight at the end that you can optimize. And here is the boss fight right here. Classic hit the on-off switch boss fight. I've done that a few times myself. Could have optimized it a little more if I had immediately recognized that it was gonna end. I wasn't counting very carefully. Leave a comment, some artwork. I don't usually draw, but sometimes I'll do it. A very stylized WR, world record. Wouldn't doubt that it's already gone. Such as my lot. I have a bronze medal in world records too, but mostly because I have so many first clears. I have 4,500 first clears and about 2,500 world records. Every time I turn on the game, I probably have 5 to 10 of those world records taken. That's why I have to keep doing first clears. First clears from very hard levels, so they can't take those ones as easily. And there we have MCW's, UK's, Toadette's Thwomp Takedown. Here is the code if you want it. Notice I only beat his upload time by a second. Okay, on to level 3. Call of Cthulhu by Escoco. Escoco is somebody I've known for a long time. But I haven't played... I shouldn't say I haven't played a lot of his levels, because I have. But, let's just say he outclasses me in skill by quite a bit. He generally makes Kaizo levels that are far too hard for me to beat. This one was given to me as I made this one easier type level. It's just a light Kaizo, actually. Jamp style level. There's no like shell stuff, no tricks. Honestly, I actually love shell levels, but I'm not that good. this one is quite doable. I died a lot, but I think I do believe the clear rate wasn't destroyed. It was about the same as when I came in, so about 2%. So that means I probably died 50 times. Mm-hmm. Yeah, pretty standard jam type stuff, or maybe you could even say ROM hack style level with these rails and stuff. Yeah, it's not a team jam level. I don't think Ascoco makes team levels. He might make some team shell levels. He has some ludicrously hard shell levels I've touched upon. I don't think I beat a single one of the shell levels. The one I remember best from him is early on, I know it's on the same account that this is on, was the walking speedrun. I highly recommend you check that one out. It's a speedrun, but if you run, it doesn't work. You have to walk, and you also have to walk fast. That's a brilliant level. Yeah, I cut out a ton of deaths in this one. I died a ludicrous amount of time, really. I mean, it's not an exceedingly hard level. But there's a lot of stuff to kill you. I think jamp levels, which generally aren't my favorite, but this one is very good. They are, they'll kill you a lot. You can get through them, and pretty much anybody with a decent amount of skill can get through most jamp levels. Guys, old light levels. But you're gonna die quite a few times doing it. Like, 2% is perfectly respectable. I think a really, really good player can read it so well. I mean, it's very easy to read, actually. Somebody like Aura or the Beast probably would die maybe once or twice on this level. Me, I'm gonna die 50 times. That's why I don't play Endless, especially Super Expert. I've never beaten more than one level on a Super Expert run. I don't think I've tried more than 5 times ever. Skip all I might. I can't get through 2 levels with 30 lives. I do try a speedrun of this. The person with a record, 51 seconds, is named Shoujo, I think? Shoujo? Something like that. I know that she is a streamer. I've actually heard of her through the Beast 721. He mentioned her at one point. I don't personally know her. She's apparently very good, and as Ascoco told me on Facebook, she grinded the crap out of this one. But I wanted to see how close I could get. I died a lot trying to optimize it, especially in the first part. I actually only got to the subworld twice before I beat it. Definitely a lot of things I could do better here, but yeah, this is it's probably a little too hard for me to care to speedrun. I don't, like I said before, I don't really try to optimize Kaizo levels. I'll let better players than me do that. I like beating them, but optimizing them too hard for me. You have to do the shortest possible jumps, things like that. Yeah, you'll see. I got that run took me 57 seconds. I'm about 5.5 seconds above her, and I was like, "Yeah, no thanks. I'm not gonna be able to get that much better than 50. I could probably get a little better than 57, but if I could cut 2 seconds off my record, I would feel pretty proud." And I beat Ascoco's upload time by nearly 1.5 seconds. The final level of the session, Septies, Chamber 37, Spanky Nuts. Spanky Nuts is another maker. Septy is a very good creator, fairly popular. He makes a lot of jamp levels, and he makes the occasional shell level. And he is a team guy. He likes to make the team levels, and that's how he gets all his plays. Never considered. Well, I shouldn't say I never considered. I don't understand Discord. It's just too. I'm too old to understand it. I look at it. It actually looks to me like a GeoCities site from 20 years ago, so I don't understand the point. Anyway, this level is very easy for a Team Shell level. Septy, he is a very good player, a very good maker. I don't think he's ever made anything I think I couldn't beat. Unlike a Skopo, who could destroy me in any day when it comes to shell stuff. I know they rank the shell levels, and my guess is this would be a one-star level, like a difficulty. Not a judgment of value, of course. it's a lot of fun. Mostly reclaims. One surf. One. I would call it a bonk. I'm not sure if it has a name. Yeah, big shell reclaims, very not that hard. Doing a running, jumping off a wall reclaim with a small shell, man, I am terrible at it. I've done it a couple of times, but if you put it in the middle of your shell level, I'll never beat that shell level. there's just a couple moves I can't do. Otherwise, if you combine a lot of them, you can get me. But this one doesn't have anything particularly difficult. I was actually looking forward to a shell jumping level. Septy actually made the chambers reference to Wu-Tang Clan 36 chamber, old kung fu movie from Shaw Brothers Studios. I know Septy is a very very huge Wu-Tang Clan fan. But yeah, he made one for me that was quite difficult. Probably still has a 2% clear rate though, because it's a Team Shell level and those people are insane. If it weren't for casuals like me, this one would probably be at like 7-8%. I don't know how many. I think I died about 50 times. Probably no more than Escoco's level. This second section after the checkpoint is a little harder than the first section. Here's the surf, the one surf. This reclaim was hard to get because you had to go pretty far to be able to make it over that piranha plant. I do want to point out some jank coming up. I can't remember which life it is, if it's right here. Watch this. Nope, not now. This big shell sometimes dies. I don't know why. I'll show it twice when it happens. I also end up reclaiming on that big shell up top several times. That ruins my rhythm and kills me. Oh, this one worked. It'll come up. I usually just show the lives where I made progress. I did die many times on that, and I missed that. Of course, I missed that coin block. I almost restart the level, which wouldn't be a disaster because it's not super hard, but it still would have sucked to have to go back to that first section. Not that it isn't fun, Septy. It's very fun. Septy also has a YouTube channel, S3PTI. He also streams on YouTube sometimes. I know he's doing on Jamp. There it is. I think I showed it twice in a row, right? Yeah, I was like, what the heck happened there? It happened to me like 3 or 4 times. I cut out the other times. Yeah, surfing, that's not a super hard surf. Sometimes surfing, it took me a while to actually get surfing down. It took me longer to get surfing down than it did like a normal shell jump. It took me a second to figure out what I was supposed to do there too. I kept knocking the plant, and I don't know if that's really indicated what you're supposed to do, but that's what I would call a bonk, where you let go and run so you don't grab the shell. I'm going to it right here again. Yep. Yeah, you don't grab the shell, you just bonk it. Yeah, I don't see that indicated, but there is a donut under the piranha plant, so it is meant to go through there. That is exactly what Septy wanted me to do. Luckily, I do that often, so it wasn't that confusing. Yeah, I think this one has a very similar clear rate to Escoco's level. It's about 2%. I don't think I lowered it, although I cut it out of the video, apparently. And that box means I'm supposed to catch that shell as a shell met, and I missed. I actually didn't recognize that on the previous life, although I died even earlier. I'm not great at looking ahead on these kind of levels. I'm doing one step at a time, and it would be much better. I would beat the levels quicker if I actually had the ability to look ahead, which I don't. If you like shell levels, I've actually made a couple. I have one really nice one in Super Mario 3 style, and I have another one in Super Mario World style that's quite hard. But yeah, very, very nice little level. I recommend it. I recommend all Aseptes levels. He's always great.